Hello, second year students. We are going to discuss about extremophiles, and here also we are going to discuss about acidophiles. So, how can we cultivate acidophilic bacteria? Acidophiles. Now, the name itself indicates that they are acid lovers. Okay. In high amount of acid, they are able to grow. Okay. Now, this acid may be anything. Okay, it may be HCl, it may be H2SO4, it may be any other acid like nitric acid or something. Okay, so these are extremophilic organisms and they grow in the presence of gases or acids which are very dangerous for other organisms. Okay, so here acidophilic organisms are grown in different ways. First of all, we will discuss about the sample collection from where they are able to be cultivated. Okay, so the place where acid is more in amount, so they are the places like the you can see acidic soils, then acidic waters, acidic water sources are also there which are connected with the soil. So these type of things like found on the earth. Okay, it may be on the surface, it may be inside the depth of the sea, or inside, it may be inside the depth of the soil. Okay, so somewhere where there will be more amount of acid, they are able to be cultivated. Okay, so we are going to take the sample from acidic soil or acidic water, and then after we will cultivate. Now, when we discuss about acidophilic bacteria, it is very surprising to us that how they are able to tolerate the acidity. Okay, so there are two mechanisms by which they are able to tolerate acidity. They have some specific mechanisms, okay, inside the bacterial cell, which will push out the protons which are accumulating in the cytoplasm, and thereby it will prevent the cytoplasm to become more acidic. So then after, there is no problem of other organelles and other biomolecules to become acidified. Okay, so that is one that they have proton pumps or mechanisms to throw out the protons outside of the cytoplasm, or if they have acidic cytoplasm, in that case they have acid stable proteins. So this is very important to understand that they have either of the two different mechanisms. Either they have capacity to push out the protons out of the cytoplasm, or if their cytoplasm is acidic, then they have acid stable proteins which will work with acidic environment. Okay, so these are the two ways how they can tolerate the acidity in the environment. Now we'll see that which are the bacteria which are considered as acidophilic in nature. So we have a very long list of bacteria. We will start with Acetobacter acidi, which is the species. Of bacteria which is highly adapted to the acidic environment. Then Thiobacillus acidophilus, and Thiobacillus acidophilus. Then Thermoplasmates, Sulfolobus, and there is one species of Sulfolobus, that is Sulfolobus acidocaldarius. Okay, so that is so this particular species of Sulfolobus is also very acid loving. And then certain organisms like Nocardiopsa, Nocardiopsis alba, so that is a species of actinomyces. mucariopsis alba. Okay, so there are various organisms which are acid lovers. Okay, now how can we cultivate them? Now when we are formulating the media for acidophilic bacteria, we have to be very careful that the environment should be acidified. Okay, the media should have extra amount of acid in its formulation. So we can have very ordinary normal media. Okay, it may be nutrient agar also, but we have to make the pH of these media very acidic. Okay, so it will be 2 to 3. Okay, then after we are able to get the growth of acidophilic bacteria. Okay, now these acidophilic bacteria are also having the same type of morphology. It will be having various type of structures found in during their life, and they are highly adapted to the acidic environment. When you get the colony of acidophilic bacteria, you are going to study the colony by two ways. First of all, you will learn the characters of colony, and other thing is you are going to get the near for gram staining, and after doing gram staining you are going for microscopy. And by doing microscopy, you can get the result in the form of different type of morphology. And on the basis of morphology as well as colony characteristics, you are able to identify the genera of particular acidophilic bacteria. Now, we are going to write down the reason. How we are going to write down the reason? So, after getting the perfect idea, we are going to write down the reasons. It will be like this, that they are gram positive or gram negative bacteria. They are either growth or cocci or cocobacilli. Okay, then after we will write that these organisms are how they are arranged. Okay, so they are arranged acinely, or they are found in bunches, or they are found in chains. This we will write, and after that we are going to write about their colorations. Okay, so they are stained by which color? So either they are stained purple color or they are stained pink color. Okay, so this is about gram staining and its observation, and from this observation and also from the colony characteristics, we are able to identify that which genus we are dealing with. Okay, thank you.